Hi and Assalamualaikum. My name is Muhammad Fakhruddin, and today I will be explaining a few of critical incidents inside the movie that I chose, which is Men in Black International. Okay, so the synopsis started as a young Molly, which is Tessa Thompson, played by Tessa Thompson, watches her parents visited by Men in Black, and she watched her parent getting neuralized by them. So since then, since she was a kid, she grows up wanting to find out and wanting to join this hidden agencies, which is the Men in Black. So in the end, she finally managed to find the Men in Black headquarters. And then from there, her stories move on, where she's been made a probation agent by Agent M. And then she was sent to London and met Agent H, which is played by Chris Hemsworth. And from there, their missions continues to grow. As well, there are a few critical incidents at the workplace that they have encountered. So let's see through it.
No, he seems pretty normal, pretty happy.
Sir, this whole thing is a fiasco. It's a farrago. And a failure of this magnitude requires immediate invokement of Article 13.
Don't be a dick. Who says farrago?
What is Article 13?
Immediate termination. Followed by neuralization.
Wait a second.
Wait.
No.
Is that your people's answer to everything?
Put that away.
On the first scene, we can see that Agency interrupts high tea discussion with Agent H&M. Not only that, Agency make a rough decision by trying to terminate Agent H&M with a neuralizer. This is a negative incident, could have an effect, which is makes Agent H&M lose respects towards Agency. Not only that, it will make Agent H&M lose confidence in themselves and making them feel more doubt about themselves. There's a ways to improve, which is agency should ask permission before speak, which shows a respect toward his boss, Haiti. Next, agency should control his emotion before making any rough decision so that he will not make a decision that will cost the department severely without a proper investigation. The theory behind this incident is theory of practice and professionalism, which is one must have patience and feelings when handling the works, which shows that agency doesn't have both of them, which he doesn't have patience and feelings when handling the works. That is why he tried to disregard or terminate Agent H&M very swiftly.
You can't.
Give me one good reason. Why not?
Well, I mean, because it's what we're talking about.
Because if you erase us, you will never know the truth.
The truth.
Come on, sir. They're obviously stalling. Say the word. I'll do it.
Put it away. Am, go ahead. Explain yourself.
On the following scene, we can see that Haiti allows Agent M, which is a probation agent, to speak and clarify her point of view, and also wait until she finishes her word. This ultimately have an effect, which is make Agent H&M their subordinates to communicate and express their opinions on Haiti to solve the problems that they have encountered just now. Next, they can share ideas and make it easier to attain goals. By sharing ideas, they know how to proceed to the next step by solving their problems in more efficient way. There is not much ways to improve on this critical incident, but we can show that, or we can assert that Haiti could be a role model towards his workers, and also to show a professional and tolerant behavior towards his worker by making a efficient decision, which is to allow Agent M to speak. So the theory behind this, which is a TRA, Theories of Reason Action, personal attitudinal judgment then result in evaluation of action. We can see that high T judgment by allowing his workers to talk result an action where they can solve the problems in an efficient way.
Awful, terrible incident in Marrakesh. The North Africa office is investigating. and in other business, H has decided to grace us with his presence after all.
Apologies, sir. It's working late. Morning, everyone.
So was I, actually, cleaning up after your mess, so thank you for that.
Oh, well, you should have seen the mess I was cleaning up this morning.
It was a...
On the final scene, we can see that it have a negative incidence, which shows Agent H enters the meeting room without knocking and also is late for the meeting. Not only that, he also make an inappropriate joke towards Agent C. We can see that as a bad manners in the workplace environment. All of these have an effect, which is everyone in the meeting room was distracted by Agent H of sudden barging into the meeting room. Also, his boss Heidi might felt offended by the displayment of discipline by Agent H, which is showing up late into the meeting room. So ways to improve it is actually Agent H need to make sure to come early into the meeting so that it will not cause any inconvenience towards others co-workers or workers. Next, Agent H should show some respect towards everyone, especially Agent C. Which is he should take the critics by agency and try to improve himself, not by making another inappropriate joke towards agency. Other than that, Agent H could also make a schedule so that he will not ever be late in a meeting again. So the conclusion is there is so much we can learn from these video excerpts from all three scenes. Where we can see that the video excerpt shows some of professional and unprofessional behaviors in the workplace. For starters, the first excerpt highlight shows that the importance of handling the work situation professionally by not making any rough decision without investigating properly, and followed by a good leadership skills shows by the high T, which is their boss, that makes the workers give the workers chance to defend themselves on the situation. And lastly, the unprofessional behavior shown by Agent H by showing up to the meeting late and making an inappropriate joke. Yeah, the bad manners on that. We can conclude that all of these aspects of communication have a very strong impact with our relationship with our co-workers. Also, we must remember that by interacting professionally with our co-workers, we have to show respect by maybe getting the critics from them, getting the critics from our co-workers and try to improve it on ourselves. Also, listen to our co-workers and observing them, have a politeness towards them in every aspect of our communication. That is all for me.
Hello, Assalamualaikum. My name is Muhammad Nakuddin. Today, I will make a video critique about Office Uprising. Office Uprising is 2018 American movie directed by Lynn Odin. This movie tells about Desmond, who is an underachiever. Desmond is stars by Brenton Twigs. He is working at Amotek, a major weapons manufacturing firm. However, Desmond discovered that the energy drink that they produce, created by the military, has turned his boss and other co-workers into a violent psychopath. Desmond will try to survive in the building with the full of psychotic co-worker. So basically, this movie is half horror, half funny. Okay, thank you.
Desi Des.
Sammy Sam.
Once again, fighting a losing battle with Mondays.
Once again, busting my balls.
Well, somebody has to do it. You haven't been on time for anything since... ever?
Not true. 2012, NYU, totally on time for your graduation ceremony.
After you went out the night before and got so drunk that you puked during my speech.
Don't take that as a criticism. It was a brilliant speech. Don't you think that maybe my problem here is I'm just not being properly incentivized?
Of course you are. You get to hang out with me every day. Give me your hand. Give me your hand. So you can at least try to be on time.
Thanks.
My gift to you.
At scene 1, we can see Desmond is a non-professional employee because he is always late to work. As Samantha said, he will never come early to the office. Samantha's comment will cause embarrassment for Desmond. So to make sure the relationship will become good, all the time. So Samantha give the end the conversation by giving her wristwatch, saying my gift to you. So Desmond will never late. This will make Desmond be more comfortable with Samantha. So Samantha do a good job there. Theory of communication. A good communication between two people always comes with respectful speaker and an attentive listener. So here we can see respectful speaker is Samantha and attentive listener is Desmond.
Helen, I'll need to remain undisturbed throughout my meetings today. Also, excellent tidy workspace. Love the lipstick. I'll take my green juice in 5 minutes.
At the following scene, we can see the boss reveals a very good work ethic and professional behavior in the workplace. This will affect the assistant will have a good day at work because the boss speak nicely and remain calm at the first day, at the morning day. And the boss even said to her that he loved the lipstick. According to communication theories, it is highly suggested to always remain calm even though one is facing pressure times. Because as we can see, the boss is having a pressure time, but he still remain calm in this scene.
Helen, hi. No, please don't get up. Don't get up. Oh, really, I could get the door myself. You know, it's really not the assistant's job to do that anymore. That's very kind of you, and thank you. Thanks for walking me. That was great.
At this scene, we can see Desmond show a very good work ethic, and he is being professional in the workplace. Even though Desmond is very late, he not even angry with the assistant. Desmond's way of react will help to lessen a problem trait and maintaining a good self image. All the employees will be more comfortable with Desmond because they know Desmond is very kind person. It is very vital for the employer and employee to be polite with each other in the workplace. Being polite and face-saving act will help removing the assumption of power. This is the theory of the work. In conclusion, I really enjoy watching this movie because it is very entertaining as well as alerting us about the reality of workplace. There are many valuable lessons that we can implement to be a good employee, such as having positive attitude, respect for colleagues, and tolerance, and being polite even though under any circumstances. We are also required to avoid any problems or issue in the workplace, such as arriving late for work and being rude to the colleagues, because this will make other colleagues will not talk to us. They will hate us. So it is very essential to practice professionalism to everyone in order to have a good environment in the workplace. That's all from me. Thank you.